This is the Sunseeker Eco Tad. Eco, in this case, meaning economical, and then Tad because it's a kind of a tadpole recumbent electric trike. And to be frank, it's actually a trike that's been converted to electric by Electric Bike Technologies. These are the guys that do ebikekit.com. They also do electrictrike.com. And I think they've done a pretty good job. By the way, forgive me, I kind of lost my voice, got a little bit of a cold recently, and I'm just recovering. But I'm having a blast on these. And this one in particular at about $1,875 is priced pretty well. Do keep in mind that with these bikes, with any of the electric trike.com bikes, you do have to pay about $350 for shipping. They do that anywhere to the contiguous U.S. states, and it comes fully assembled, ready to ride. And they like to say, like, the key is in the ignition. And I must say, like, that's totally worth it, in my opinion, versus buying and then trying to convert yourself. They do a really great job of just all the cabling and everything, and dialing in the display placement and all the controls, even getting that cadence sensor all hooked up. This is a 12 magnet pedelec sensor, and it's really nice because, you know, it's going to be more responsive than 6 magnet, some of the other designs that I've tried. For some reason, whenever I get on recumbent trikes, it seems like I'm in a higher gear, and I think that's because they're so aerodynamic, you end up going a little bit faster. So it's kind of nice that you have a cadence sensor that's just so responsive. You don't have to pedal for quite as long until the motor helps you out, or you don't have to pedal at all because this one actually has a trigger throttle as well. At any time, you can kind of add to assist. It doesn't override assist at full power. Instead, it's incremental. So you've got 5 levels of assist over here, and as you go from 1 to 5, you get increasing power and increasing top speed. The top speed on this trike is 26 miles per hour, about, you know, 26, 27. So it's kind of a speed pedelec unless you go in and dial it down. You totally can. You can turn down the current, you can turn down the top speed, and you can even sort of change how pedal assist responds, like how quickly. So it's very customizable. That's one of the big highlights on these trikes is the display. It pivots so you can adjust and make sure there's not as much glare, but it is not removable. And at first I was looking, I was like, wow, you know, it looks like an iPod Nano or something like that. It is backlit. If you hold up on the control pad for a few seconds, it comes to life. And that's really a nice feature. In this case, it's a little more in your face than some of the other ones. I've seen it way out here, but it feels like it's pretty well protected right there. And then you don't have to worry about reading those as different indicators and stuff. So let's get back to the trike. You know, it's fairly adjustable. As with most recumbent trikes, the boom sort of goes in and out, and then the seat, you can see it kind of bolted right there, slides forward and back, and then it's adjustable angle at the back as well. So you get good support. You have a nice rack here, standard gauge tubing with a nice pannier blocker, so you can hang some extra gear off the back or get like a little saddle bag. There's even a little mount there at the back for adding a light. I would totally do that, especially on a recumbent. You just want to be seen. You might have something on the back of your helmet back here. That's a good option as well. And then somehow adding a headlight. That's something I haven't completely figured out yet. There's a couple little mounting points right here that you can mess around with. And then I love that they've got a couple of extra bosses here behind the seat for adding bottle cages. So 2, so you could have a folding lock on one side, a bottle cage on the other. It's a nice setup. I noticed that the cover here, it's designed to be breathable. It's padded on the seat and removable as well. So when you're taking a recumbent trike like this and deciding to convert it to electric, one of the big considerations I like to think about is braking power. And this has 160 millimeter Pro Max mechanical disc brakes. And they brake independently. So the left lever brakes the left wheel, and you can kind of use that to maneuver a little bit more tightly. These are flippable. It's pretty easy to accidentally roll it, especially if you're doing a sharp turn. It's not even about high speed. It's more about the terrain. And that has to do with this being recumbent. Most of the weight on this bike is towards the rear. The battery itself weighs about 9.3 pounds. I think the overall weight of this is about 72 pounds, so you know, it's a little bit heavier, and part of that's because it's got a pretty impressive 500 watt nominal 1000 watt peak internally geared hub motor back here. And you can see the thicker spokes, they look like 12 gauge to me. The tires are all pretty consistent across this 20 by 1.5, I believe they're the Kenda Quest, right? Exactly. And then, you know, because of the power that you're dealing with here, about 45 newton meters, they've got these, I think it's brass eyelets and nipples. It's designed so that the rim is a little bit stronger. It won't crack as easily. Just a pretty good upgrade there compared to the front where it's 14 gauge. You can see they're a little bit thinner and they don't have those eyelets, so the rims might not be quite as strong. Yeah, it's nice to see that kind of thing. But yeah, a lot of the weight is towards the rear. Thankfully, you know, the motor weight's a little bit lower. The battery, you know, it could be placed somewhere else, but I, you know, frankly, I think that that's the most accessible. You can charge it on or off the frame, and sometimes it's like, where's the charging port? Well, it's right there. You've got to flip that handle up in order to reach it. You do have to leave the key in order to operate this thing. If I wanted to take it off, I just twist to the left and then kind of push it in, twist it a little bit more, and then I would start sliding this like this. But look, the key collides with the rack. You're probably not going to bust it or anything, but that's just something to be aware of. You got to kind of take the key out in order to get it off. Pretty nice key, by the way. Sort of internally routed versus the old-fashioned ones. And then you can see the plug over here. They don't use proprietary batteries, which is one of the neat, like, I guess just longevity considerations with an electric trike. If you go with something that's, you know, like a purpose-built trike and all the cables are internally routed and stuff, you're definitely going to be paying more, and then you're kind of locked into their batteries and stuff, versus this is a little bit more standard. It's got that aluminum shell. I think it actually works pretty well. You know, I gripe about the keys and stuff as like an extra step a lot of times on electric bikes, like, oh, you're pedaling, are you going to hear jingling and stuff? And if you take your key off of this keychain and then you just leave it in like this, it's not really in the way. You're not going to pedal and kick it, so that's less of a consideration for me here. You just plug this back in, the Molex adapter right there. Make sure it's all the way forward. There we go. And then we can move up to the front of the bike. You can see here that we've got a nice chain guide. So that's another little upgrade, something that's nice to see so you don't lose the chain. It's a 7-speed bike. You can see that the chain goes through this nice kind of a plastic tube. It's designed to just keep it from getting your pants greasy and stuff, keep it from rattling around as much. There's a little bit more friction as a result, and I guess I've just found that that's how it works on most recumbent bikes. When we come back here, we've got a Sunrace M30. Not a derailleur I've really heard of or familiar with. But that, I think that's kind of their in-house brand for the Sunseeker line. So, you know, got a decent set of chain rings, or sprockets rather, in the rear. 7 speeds, it's like, you know, it's enough. And when you've got that throttle and you can just kind of overpower it, you really don't need to pedal as much. It's kind of a decent commuter if you lived somewhere. You were on a budget and you wanted to get around town and you preferred this setup, something that's a little bit more stable, a little bit more aerodynamic. This is one of your most affordable options. And, you know, I think it gets the job done. It definitely checks the boxes that way. So let me talk a little bit more about just activating it and stuff. I was over here a minute ago talking about the key. It's in, it's locked, it's ready to go. We hold the power button for a couple seconds on this ring. It's not quite as close and reachable as on some of the other bikes where it's mounted over here, but that's because of the displays there. So they've kind of made some trade-offs. They're doing their best. The other buttons are just up and down. The display gives us a battery power indicator up at the top. It's really 5 chunks. I know it looks like a lot more, actually 15 little increments, but they disappear in 20% increments. So it's like, you know, that's all right. That's kind of standard. Speed, it's in miles per hour. You can switch it to kilometers per hour. Assist level, we're in 3 right now, but remember there are 5, so if I want, I can take it all the way down to 0. Pedal this just like a normal bike and save my battery and just use this as a cycle computer. And then down at the bottom right now it says odometer. but I can change that to trip meter and average speed up at the top. I can go to max speed and trip B. So they have like two trips, which is kind of cool. The other thing I want to call out on the brake levers here is that they have motor inhibitors in line. So let's say you're in pedal assist and you really need it to respond right away. Like there's an emergency, you need to stop. You don't want to be fighting that motor, and you won't be, because as soon as you pull either one of those levers, it's going to stop you. And I noticed they have built in like little kind of locks, and that's a really cool parking brake that I see a lot on recumbent trikes. So they didn't skimp on any of the necessary hardware here. They have safety cover, they have parking covered, they've got the braking in a good state. You know, these aren't hydraulic brakes, they're not the super, super fancy stuff, but this thing definitely gets the job done, and it could be a you know, fairly practical commuter. Pick it up from the back like this, it's easy enough to walk it around, get it started, get it going. I've taken some more measurements and stuff back at the site, so, you know, definitely check that out if you're thinking about, like, will this fit through my doors, or, you know, what's the deal, because it doesn't have quick release on the wheels or anything. It's a little bit bigger, more to deal with than other traditional electric bikes, but again, you get the advantages of some comfort, some aerodynamics, and maybe this is just how you prefer to ride. I think it's pretty cool. Hey, so this is Alec. He's been helping me out. We've been getting this thing dialed in, and I've been having him adjust the setup, just the fit and everything. I was gonna go ahead and hop on for a minute, but maybe when I'm done, will you hop on too? And
yeah, absolutely.
Pedal around. It's fun to see, you know, a third person.
This is one of my favorite ones, actually. It's really sporty.
What do you like about it?
It's so low to the ground that you get like really good control, and you can go really fast. It makes a nice road bike, and it's simpler because it's one of the lower cost bikes. There's not as much equipment, as much gear changing. You just have the single speed.
Yeah.
So it's like, it's a nice simple bike, and it's just fun to take it down the road.
Yeah, I think about that sometimes, where it's like, sometimes you spend so much on a bike, you're like afraid to ride it.
Yeah.
You know, what could happen? But this one at like, you know, $1,900-ish plus the $350, it's like, you know, to be able to get an electric recumbent, that's a speed pedal like with a throttle.
Yeah.
For that kind of price, the low 2000s is not bad, man. I appreciate that perspective. And it's still adjustable, you know? It's neat that it doesn't feel like you're missing out on too much.
Yeah, you can still slide the seat forward and back. You can still angle the seat. You can still move the boom up and down.
Is this one that you guys also get feedback? You know, we were talking earlier, these guys also sell, you know, the more traditional tricycles. And it sounds like maybe an older audience tends to gravitate towards that. And they're like, I want to slow it down. I want to feel in control.
Yeah.
This one, like you're saying, it's more sporty.
Yeah.
You still can dial in the amperage and you can lower the top speed, but...
Yeah, you can still slow this down. We target this more towards going fast. You know, it's got the 48 volt on it, so you can get up to 26 or 28 miles an hour. But you can always turn it down. You can turn down the PAS, or you can turn down the throttle using the screen or the settings. But even so, the real joy of this is to get nice and low to the ground and find a nice windy road and like really let it rip.
Oh yeah, it's like a race car. And I've seen even fairings and stuff that I don't know if there's a mounting kit or something like that. I suppose with a little bit of effort, anything is possible.
Absolutely. And that, you know, these are really aerodynamic to start with, but if you were to put a fairing on it, you could really fly.
When it's only 7 speeds back here, we were talking about that. It's like, well, some people are used to having like 28 or something.
Exactly.
But, you know, at the 26, 27 mile per hour, what do you think in terms of the cadence?
Yeah, I think you can hold a decent, at 28 miles an hour, you can hold a decent like 90 RPM for sure.
Yeah.
So it's geared well for that. And with the gears, it's less about the number of gears you get than the quality of them. If you take a look here, what it's got is a nice range between the high 13 and the low 32. So you have a nice big jump there. You have a comprehensive choice between your high gears and your low gears.
Yeah, and that's the starter gear, right? That's kind of your granny gear,
hill climber. Yeah, so you get started there. And then the electric makes up for any gaps you might have.
Yeah.
So definitely if you're used to having, you know, 28 gears, if you like 10 speed, 11 speed, it's a whole lot less.
Yeah.
But you might find that the range you get is actually kind of similar, even though you don't have quite as many.
I appreciate that perspective. You know, I was back here looking at the spokes and everything, and it's like, I'm not as familiar with the Sunrace brand or some of these other things, but yeah, I think it looks pretty nice and it checks the box, you know?
Yeah.
It's not a single speed.
Yeah, so. It's a lot of fun to ride.
Sweet. Okay, I'm gonna hop on this thing and just cruise around. I'll be back in a second.
Cool.
Okay, so you kind of mount it like that. You step over to the side, maybe grab a handlebar. They're back here. Pretty tight steering. I'm just going to go ahead and activate with that trigger throttle. I am in the highest level of power right now. Oh boy. Getting it up close to that 20 miles per hour. I'm riding without lights on a street right now, so I want to be careful. I can hear the motor whining a little bit more. I think it's just because it's operating at that higher amperage. It's a little bit bigger than a lot of the other motors I try. Got those disc brakes down there doing a good job. Hey.
Hey, how'd it go?
It went pretty well.
Nice.
Do you mind if I could watch you hop on that and just get a third, you know, just around the parking lot. It doesn't need to be. It's getting a little dark and we just want to be safe here.
Yeah.
Nice. Maybe you can brake right here, get a little. Yeah, very nice. It's pretty quiet.
Yeah.
You know? Thank you so much, Alec.
Yeah,
I appreciate getting a little help here today, dialing it in. I've had a lot of fun with this one. You know, it's nice to be able to feel like I could, you know, buy this without breaking the bank. It would come. It's all assembled and stuff. The way that you guys set it up is really nice. There's a year-long warranty from these guys too. You know, it doesn't have quite all of the extra fancy features and stuff, but I really like that display. That's pretty nice. You just want to take care of it so it doesn't get, you know, it's not removable, and it's a really nice display. So it's like, I'm just thinking, like, is there a way to cover it up or just something that way? But the battery is removable, and that's a big deal in terms of weight and just charging it separately in case you park this out in your garage or something. And I think that's it. I totally welcome feedback. I know there are some people out there that love their recumbent trikes, and maybe you can sound off with some of the more technical like details and ideas, but you know, I'm impressed. So for the full write-up on this, all the other specs I talk about, I'll see you back at ElectricBikeReview.com. And of course, especially at night, ride safe or get some of those lights.